बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। आई एम सैयद अरफानुल्लाह, एडवोकेट, पेशावर हाई कोर्ट, इनकॉर्पोरेट लॉ, एंड अ विजिटिंग लेक्चर एट फ्रंटियर लॉ कॉलेज पेशावर। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द काइंड्स ऑफ कंपनीज आर द टाइप्स ऑफ कंपनीज। वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कंपनीज and how the companies can be formed. Today this is an extension to the previous lecture and we are discussing the kinds of companies or the types of companies. So this is the complete picture of the different type of companies. So you can see the company can be divided into the following types. On the basis of incorporation, on the basis of liability, the number of members, control, and the ownership. So if we look at the type of companies on the basis of incorporation, so again it is divided into three types, that is the chartered companies, the statutory companies, and the registered companies. We will discuss its kinds in more detail, although some are not in your course contents or in your course, but we will have to go through a brief introduction to these types of the companies on the basis of the incorporation and the other ones. On the basis of the liability, so on the basis of the liability, there are two major types of the companies. One is called the limited companies and the other one is called unlimited companies. So normally you can see that it is written with some of the companies, Habib Bank Limited, Allied Bank Limited, similarly Diwan Fibers Limited, or unlimited companies. Normally it is not written with the names of the companies. So if it is not written with the companies, so normally these are treated with the unlimited companies on the basis of the liability. It is not a general rule, but normally it is assumed like this, that if the limited word is not written with a company name, so it is unlimited, but it is not a hard and fast rule. The company can be divided on the basis of the number of members also, that is the private company and the public company. So how much of the members of the company can be, so on the basis of that it is the companies are divided into the private companies and the public companies. On the basis of the control, the companies are divided to the holding and subsidiary. That who will control and how a company could be controlled. So on the basis of that, these are the two types. And the according to the ownership, there are two types of companies. On the ownership, that is the government companies and non-government companies. So you should not confuse this with the private companies and the public companies, because a government company, normally it is called a public company, but it is not always the case that how much of the members of that government company could be and how it is formed, this is something else. And some is the case with the non-government companies, that the companies who are not owned by the government but the private people. So these are interrelated to one another. For example, a private company can be unlimited, private company can be unlimited, a private company could be a chartered company, and so forth. But this is the general description or the general division, that when we are looking at the formation of the companies, the types of the companies, So we divide these companies into the following parts. So on the basis of incorporation, chartered companies, statutory companies, registered companies, on the basis of the liability, the limited and the unlimited companies, the member, number of members, so the private and the public, the number of members is different, the control, the holding and subsidiary, and the ownership, the government and the non-government. So the classification of companies on the basis of the incorporation, we have discussed this in the previous class also, the formation of the companies, and it is an extension to that, as I said, on the basis of incorporation. So the chartered companies, companies set up as a result of a royal charter granted by a king or queen of a country are known as a chartered company. For example, an East India Company or the Bank of England, we discussed in the previous lecture. Statutory companies, the companies set up by a special act of the parliament or state legislature are called statutory companies. For example, Reserve Bank, there are different companies. In Pakistan, you can see WAPDA, OGDCL, PTCL. These are the companies made by the Act of the Parliament. The registered companies, the companies, those are registered under the 1985 Companies Act or the 2013 Companies Act or the 2017 Companies Act. Under the previous Companies Act, all the registered companies, most of the companies in Pakistan belongs to this category. India and Pakistan, because the company law is almost same all over the world. I'm not saying all over the world, but it is almost same, because the companies are doing their businesses with one another, and they are holding the rules and regulation normally same as the international law permits. The licensed companies, the companies established under the promotion of arts, science, religion, charity or other similar objects, can obtain a license from the central government and enjoy certain privileges. For example, you make a medicine company. Now you wish to do a medicine business, so you take a license. Other than this, if you have a charity, the government gives you a license, giving you a permission to work in that specific area, like the non-governmental organization or the NGOs. So you are being given a license, and on the basis of that, then you are doing that specific business. Same is the case, you see, with the atta dealers, the sugar dealers, and these who are given a license for doing a business in a specific area. And normally, when you purchase something, you see these license clips in these shops and different locations also. The foreign companies, a company incorporated outside Pakistan under the law of a country of incorporation but having established in its business in Pakistan is called the foreign company. So these are the companies, those are made for a specific purpose, that they are doing the business, like the offshore companies, they are doing the business outside, but the ownership is with the residents of the country. They are established as business in Pakistan or the related countries, but they can do the business outside the country also. So this has a number of people, because there are some limited those come in my mind and I cannot share those things. But sometimes for specific tasks, a government creates a company for an export or an import on temporary basis normally, and sometimes on permanent basis, and they are doing a business and they purchase the goods from the other countries under their specific act or under their specific brand or name, and they import it to their base countries and they export from the base countries to the other countries also. Thank you. I am Saeed Irfanullah. The corporate law educate and a visiting lecture at Frontier Law College, Peshawar. Thank you.